Yesterday I saw so many posts about only now we are understanding Krishna's sacrifice. Hey, I tell you, even his Rasa Leela is an extreme sacrifice. It is not womanizing our polygamous as dash, dash, dash fellows distort the illegitimate sons of 3 M's. Distort Krishna's life, Rama's life, and abuse Hindus, make Hindus feel respect for their tradition and civilization. As they describe, it is neither womanizing nor polygamous. Understand? Hey, first of all, the whole Rasalila happened when Krishna was a kid, not even 10 year old. Before 10, he already moved to Mathura. The whole thing happened in Vrindavan before 10. Unless he is real all right, let me not get into that subject. Now let me only tell what I need to tell. Because I have very spicy words for this anti-Hindu gang. I just silence myself. Okay, let me do my work, creative work, because Krishna Janmashtami is coming. So let me explain about Krishna and induce more love, bhakti, devotion about Krishna, and let you all start manifesting Krishna. Let's enjoy Krishna. Let's celebrate Krishna. Why waste time on gamsas and sisubalas and bloody dash, 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 dash narakasuras? No, no need. Let them live their life. Let us live our life. Listen. Everything about Krishna's life is absolute sacrifice. Sarva parityaga for the humanity. Whether he gave life to the 16,000 women whom he rescued from Narakasura's hell, or he himself created a controlled condition and diffused all the weapons, most dangerous weapons, and all those people who can multiply those weapons finished them off, killed them literally, eliminated them. So planet Earth is safe. Planet Earth again becomes a place to live. Killing Bhishma, killing Drona was basic requirement. Because anyone goes and begs, serves Drona, he is going to teach them Brahmastra. And after learning that Brahmastra, whether that fellow is going to be dharmic or just going to justify his delusional arrogance as dharma, who knows? So killing Drona was absolute necessary. Killing Bhishma was absolute necessary. Krishna took everything upon himself. That is why I wanted the Partha Sarathi form of Krishna to be worshipped. Only then you will understand his sacrifice, where he is just resting in the beach of Chennai. Salty air burns the wounds but heals quickly. That is why he went to the Triplicane. He went to Triplicane and rested there for recovery of all the wounds from the body after the war. I want the Parthasarathi form of Krishna to be worshipped. To remember the extreme sacrifice, even physically. Hey, don't think he was all the time being served by Gopikas and all his Ashtasakis, always in the bed with best food, dress, comforts and best women. No. Stop projecting your fantasies on him. He was extremely sincere, compassionate, integrated leader, acharya, guide. Training people. Finally, he gave his own Narayani Sena to fight against him. He is in Pandava's side and he gifted his Narayani Sena to Gauravas. And Narayani Sena did a very integrated job. They did not drop their weapons because Krishna is on the other side. They obeyed his words than their personal attachment to him. What a personality he built. That is Krishna. His own people take his words more important, his command is important than their personal attachment to him. God. And they also know nothing can be done to him. He is too big.